Well, I have to say, so as I sat down to prepare for this, I look back and I see January 16th, 1970, the beginning of Erica Kane. Now, when I say that, and when you think back to you, does that seem like yesterday, or does that seem like, who is that girl and when was that?
You know, it doesn't seem like yesterday, but probably if you told me it was 10 years ago, I would believe that. I mean, it has flown. Time has gone by so fast.
I mean, I was like, oh my God. Did you ever think when you went for that role that you would have a 41-year starring role on one show forever, you know, 41 years?
Never. In fact, I had to be persuaded by my agent at the time to sign that first contract, which was for 4 years.
Wow.
Because 4 years at that time, I had, you know, I just gotten out of college. So 4 years of high school, 4 years of college, that was like a whole lifetime. You know, I didn't know if I could do that, sign up for anything for 4 more years.
When we're young, didn't 4 years sound like, wait a second, that's just way too much commitment for anything.
Exactly, yes.
Was it always acting for you growing up? Like, did you ever think you wanted to do anything else?
I always wanted to be an actress since I can remember, probably before I ever even heard the word actress. I mean, it was just what I did. I made up stories and acted all the parts. And my mother was really nice. She let me go in her top drawer of her dresser and get out all her scarves. And my uncle had traveled to Asia, and my mother didn't smoke, but she had this long cigarette holder and she had long silk gloves. And at that time, there were these wire things with jewels on them, and women used to wear their chignons like Grace Kelly. And my mother would pull her hair back, and that's what would hold her chignon. But I could make it a crown. I could make it really anything.
Wow. So it really was always acting.
Always. And I would put on Broadway cast albums that my parents had, and I would sing and dance all over the house. And as long as I didn't have my shoes on, my mother would let me jump all over the furniture and pretend I was, you know, dancing.
I love it. Do you have, like, what are some of your early memories of being on the set of All My Children, like right in the beginning? You know, you were green. It was your first, you know, big job. Like, what do you remember from that time?
Well, I remember being really, really feeling like I was under the gun. I was very nervous. I knew I had had really good teachers, and, you know, I was doing everything that they were had taught me to do. They were wonderful. But we were on the, there were four of us who were playing the high school kids, which was unusual for four kids to be playing, have a major role.
Yeah.
Soap opera. Anyway, we were on probation. The four of us were on probation for the first 5 episodes. So, you know, the network could change their mind and we knew it. So I, for one, was very scared.
Do you you know, from all those times that, you know, all those years, do you have like a high that sticks out of like all of Erica's storylines? Is there one or two that are just like, those are your favorites?
Oh, you know, Erica was a really busy character. I was a really lucky actress. So on a really light note, the other thing that Agnes was so groundbreaking, Agnes Nixon, who created All My Children, and Erica Kane. But she, I mean, as far as I know, before Agnes, there was no real glamour either on daytime television. It was no humor, there was no glamour. It was just a lot of drama, wonderful drama. But she also brought in glamour and humor. But she had the first really light storyline that I loved was a very glamorous one where Erica was a model. And I remember that we also went out on location, and that was unheard of. We shot all over New York City. It was December, it was freezing. I was in little tiny dresses and lying on marble, something with a fountain outside of Lincoln Center, and up on top of the fountain in front of the Plaza Hotel. And I was in a little chiffon dress. And the men below me, I could see them on Fifth Avenue. They were selling chestnuts. They had on parkas. It was some of my best acting because I had to be all, you know, happy and smiling like nothing was there in terms of the cold weather. But It was so much fun. Coming down the steps, the grand staircase at the Metropolitan Museum of Art. I mean, I had some wonderful, really wonderful experiences. And also the hair and makeup was very high fashion. And that was very fun. It was fun. You know, this was a fantasy come true. This was exciting to do. And then there were the, of course, the more serious storylines, which, you know, as an actress, I was very grateful to have two of them involved Bianca at different ages. The one actually that won the Emmy for was the time where the 11-year-old Bianca was saying that she had anorexia, and we did an intervention. I would say the storyline that I'm most proud of is when the 16-year-old Bianca came out to Erica, and Agnes and her writers wrote this storyline in real time. So it was a 2-year journey, and it was so well done, so well cast. I love Eden Regal, who played Bianca, and it had impact. It had impact on the world.
It did. Like, I mean, as a gay man and a member of the gay community, and like, you know, I have a ton of lesbian friends. Like, that's the first thing they say when I told them I was speaking to you. They're like, you have to talk about Bianca. And I mean, that storyline just still stands out to people.
Thank you.
I mean, you know, you also had some food fights, and you wrestled a bear, and you buried some people in the backyard. I mean, there were those stories too, of course.
which were wonderful and so much fun. I mean, when they told me I was going to fight a grizzly bear and win, I thought, I would try anything in rehearsal. I always will. And at the time, I just remember saying to Jackie Babin, who was our producer at the time, we were way up north in Canada, about 2.5 hours north of Toronto, in a place called Peterborough, I think it was. And it was on the Great Lakes. And anyway, it was a very hot, humid July day. And there was the bear and his trainer. Oh, and wow. I said to Jackie, so I'm going to fight this grizzly bear and win. And she said, yeah, just try it. And I said, don't you think we've gone too far this time? She said, no, just try it. So I said, of course, okay, I'll try it. Anyway, the bear was being kept cool in a stream. And then the trainer got the bear out, and he was groaning. He did not want to work. And I'm thinking, oh, great. How am I going to win this? And anyway, I tried it. That was it. And we did the scene, and it turned out to be a classic, I think, in the fans' delight level. They really loved it.
It's just like, what's happening? Erica, of course she's going to win against a bear. Like, that makes total sense, right? I mean, what was there anything, you know, like, I know you also dealt with, like, you guys had the first legal abortion on TV, which was another like really serious storyline. What about, was there anything that jumped the shark, or was it the bear where you're just like, I think we went too far here, guys. Like, I need to speak to someone.
Yeah, there was a time where I think when Phil came back from Vietnam and he wanted Erica to be barefoot and pregnant all the time. And there were actually scenes where Erica was ripping out ads from the newspaper about houseplants. And I remember thinking, this just not, and I said, you know, I'll do this, but this does not seem like Erica at all. And in fact, she didn't stay in that chained in place for very long. She went up going to New York and resuming her modeling career, and burst into song in Brandon Kingsley's office, you know, New York, New York, that's where she belonged.
Between that and like wrestling the bear, that's where it's just like, this is amazing. Well, like you said, like Agnes Nixon was so groundbreaking. I mean, how great was it to work with her all those years?